Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind for your Commodore Amiga. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We're at the... or we're near the Palace of Strog? Or no, Scat. Or Sakat. It is at... the coordinates 127, 182. And we're at 127, 188. So we should just be able to march directly north and go in there, so... done. So we need some light, obviously. Gonna use up these lanterns and save my mana for the protective spells. Doorway, and otherwise... let's see if there's any secrets in the room. Not seeing anything of the sort. All those shelves over there? Let's head west first. There's a sign there. There's a few signs. What do the signs say? The sign advises, to the south, fire giants from the Hoyman Desert, Lyramion. Fire giants. I've never seen fire giants on Lyramion. The sign says, to the north, the fire dragon from Luminor's Tower in Lyramion. Take care. Well, this place is set up like some kind of zoo or something, but with open doors. Got a switch. Oh. As you enter, you immediately notice the mighty cage hanging in the middle of the room. In it, there crouch four huge dragons. While they look at you in astonishment, the cage door suddenly opens and the dragons leap out and attack you. That they do. Alright. So if anyone gets killed here, I can easily leave. And resurrect somebody at least. Alright, so I'm putting... this guy in the corner up here to sleep. I'm trying to. It'll probably work. I'm defending. We'll all attack this one. Means they're gonna get blasted by three dragons still, even if it does work. I think it worked. Oh wow, we killed it that quickly. Oh, fire! Oh, these are fire dragons, not actual... I'm curious. Let's do the monster LP. I thought these were Morag dragons, because we keep coming across them. Let's put this one over here to sleep. So, wow, these are like the ones we fought in Luminor's Tower, is that what it said? Oh, that one's asleep. Because that, I remember how tough those were, and now they're easy. That. Did we get the monster LP? We did. 130 hit points. I don't remember attacking that one. Oh, whatever. Yeah, I'm gonna cast sleep again. Just because Edgel's not in this fight, so it could take two rounds rather than one. To take this one down, possibly. Critical hit, nope. 107 damage. Now I was saying it was the last episode or the one before. Last session, definitely. That we have not seen his critical hits for quite some time. So it could be it just doesn't work on the Morag stuff, the Morag enemies. Because these are supposed to be from Lyramion, apparently. I'm not gonna bother with the sleep spell this time. Wow. That was easy. Easiest battle for quite a while. Alright, so they were... all four of them, supposedly, in this little cage here. Why do I find it hard to buy that? In this room, there hangs the gigantic cage in which five fire giants are sitting or lying. All of a sudden, the door springs open and the giants leap out and rush at you. I thought that was in the other room. Did I leave that room? I'm sure these guys throw some kind of spell. Throw this one in the corner to sleep. Anyone hurt? No. No one's even hurt. Wow. Agile did 50 damage there. He single-handedly killed that thing. Fire beam. Agile deflected. Selena deflected that one. Alright, so I believe that one's asleep. They're just casting fire beam. I have a feeling we're just going to take out both of these in this round, and this guy should be still asleep. I should save the same one. Doesn't matter. As I've said a lot of times, I just save in case equipment breaks. And even then, if we lose a Morag Dart, we have so many others to replace them. So I wouldn't restore in that case for the Morag Dart. But I haven't seen... yeah, see what I mean? We haven't seen... oh, he woke up. You woke up all by yourself? What a big boy. Alright. Full healing on Agile. I guess I went into the other room. Just kind of curious to see. Maybe I did Find a secret wall into another room. 500 experience. I'll take the gold. I don't think I even need the gold anymore. This is regular leather and clubs? Yeah, I believe it. I don't think we broke into another room. I don't think that was supposed to happen like that. Looking for any secrets. Well, there's a switch. I don't want to pull it yet because I don't know what it does. Alright, put in our first save. So yeah, I think they came out of this room for some reason. I don't know how the game confused and thought we were over here. We were just walking around in that room. So here's another switch. Alright, doesn't seem to be any secret or illusory walls in this room. Or in that room. What about otherwise? Now we don't have to test these walls because we know they go into there, but like starting here, that's the entrance. Okay. More signs and stuff. More exhibits. This one's a little more interesting. Fighting more varied creatures. To the south, minotaurs from Sansri's Island, Lyramion. To the north, imps from the forest of Lyramion. Imps, really? Been a while. Am I right that magic doesn't harm them? Or only magic harms them? Something like that? This is a convenient place. If you blunder into some trap. This room is almost completely filled by a huge cage containing lots of imps. It is not. They look at you with interest, but suddenly the door of the cage springs open and the imps attack you without hesitation. Wow. Do we even need to be worried about these things? There's a lot of them. Let's try to at least cut down the number of attacks, I suppose. Oh, Oh wow. Selena and Valden defeated that one by themselves. Okay. Drug spell. Oh, this is always fun. I think that worked. Mudsling spell. Just 6 points. Melvin deflected. Windhowler. Who's that hitting? Valden. Well. Let's heal Valden then. I'm drugged. Defend. Next. Next. I didn't miss that part. Okay, I'm defending, right? No. Okay, next person. Alright. Attack the imp. I'm gonna put this one to sleep. It's really the effects we don't like. Alright, well, Edgel's attacking this one. Edgel's gonna single-handedly kill this one, so let's let Valden and Selena attack the one behind it. That one's sleeping, that one will be asleep, probably. I'm defending and drugged. So, I don't know if that wears off once the battle's over. I'll have her, do something. Do we have remove drugged? We do. But I can't cast it. We need to be in camp. I'm gonna be drugged the whole time? That's gonna be annoying. I think we might be able to use one of the herbs we have or something to remove that effect? Not sure. Well, I'll run out and fix that. It's not a big deal to leave here. Okay, so we've gotten rid of that one. Oh, and the imp deflected the sleep spell. We kill that one. Oh, that one woke up. They're all awake. Cause aging spell. Well, that worked. I don't want aging to be going on. Oh, here it is. I wasn't even looking at him because it was grayed out. Alright, so that's another thing we have to go into camp to fix, I guess. Just gonna have him defend. Because once we move up, he'll hit this one. I think as long as I can select the enemy correctly, I won't hit Malden. We're fine. Let's see if Nelvin can put this one to sleep at least for a little bit. I forgot to redirect someone's attack, I think. Selena. Imp deflected a sleep spell. Alright. Two points of damage on Valden. Oh no. He'll never recover. I'm attacking. Next person. Attack that one. No one really needs to be fixed up, really. Wind Howler on this guy, then. Deflected. It just did 99 points of damage on that thing. I don't feel like dealing with my drug self right now. You're doomed. Agile, level 37. Life points did not go up with 77 training points. Still 7 attacks per round. I wonder if he goes up even more at some point. Oh, it's me. Alright. Can we cast this? No. We have to be in sleep. We have to be in camp mode. Let's leave and come back. Meh. Defend. Okay. The drug state is entertaining to me. It's an interesting yet annoying mechanic. I didn't really miss it, but I was entertained by it. So, make of that what you will. As long as it doesn't happen all the time. It's pretty rare. I think it's only the spiders that would do that to us. But apparently imps as well do that. Been so long since we fought the imps. Probably like a year in my time, so I don't remember if they drugged us before. Add a shadow. Alright, we need to heal these effects. Oh, not that. That would have actually been bad. Probably because he would have been aging while we were sleeping. Heal aging. And then remove drugged. Ah! What a rush! Alright. We're out here. Let's see, we don't even really need to sleep, but we might be facing a lot more tougher things ahead, like the boss battle, so while we're out here, might as well take advantage of that. Alright, so I'm gonna give him Balden one ration. I'm also gonna give Nelvin one ration. Oh. Or I'm not. He's weighed down. Because now he has the amber. He's not weighed down now. He doesn't have any slots free. And here, take the topaz. Alright, so I'm still trying to give him one ration. These guys are fine. Zero, zero. I need one. I like the song. It's pretty rare to hear it go this far. Alright, so we have to wait. Good once more. Oh, we need to put our protections back on. Barrier. Attack. And anti-magic sphere. And I insist. Thank you. Oops. I hit that because I was going forward. So what did they say? What were the other things we have to face? Imps and then... Oh, Minotaurs. So I guess we'll be fighting those Minotaurs next. Experts in killing such as you. Just lay down and let us slice you to ribbons. Thank you. Nelvin, level 47. Life points did not go up. I don't know about the power points. They are now 740 in any case. 254 spell learning points and 140 training points. And money. Look at the money starting to weigh us down. Oh, let's get into the castle? Or palace? Who put that there? I'm glad there's no more math puzzles. That was driving me insane. Alright, let's look around the room. See if it chips off the Minotaurs, just looking around in here. Don't seem to be any secrets in this room. Okay. I know I checked this ball. I don't think there'd be a secret here because of the signs, but there's a look. Thank you. want to turn, right? It's a new one, yeah. In the huge cage in this room, there are several of the horrible minotaurs from Sansri's followers. Just as you notice them, the cage door springs open for no apparent reason, and, howling, the minotaurs leap towards you. Indeed. They certainly do. You know, I'm not even gonna bother putting these things to sleep. Which is the, Wind Devil? No. Whirlwind, I think, right? That hits everybody? Yeah, Whirlwind. Ooh, casting Earthquake. That hits everybody, I think, right? So being deflected. Yeah, it hits everybody. Oh, there's another one. Not doing a lot of damage, just damaging a lot of people. I'll make the whole screen flicker. Damn. Failed. Failed. Good. Good. Whirlwind. I have a feeling two whirlwinds might kill these things. Expecting Edgel to take this one down. Fifty damage. There he goes. So defending, and I'm gonna try another whirlwind. And we're all hitting this one. And who is most damaged? Nelvin, of course, 173. Alright, small heal on Nelvin. I don't want them to take him out with successive hits. All these earthquakes in a row. We might just kill this one here. In front of Katrine. Yes. Four left. Spell failed. Here's my whirlwind. Is that killing him? Maybe three attacks of it. That would be a good way to take out the ones in the back. So Susan needs to heal somebody. He's gonna go whirlwind one more time. 208. Yeah. Small heal on Sabine herself. Boom, boom, boom. Nice. Three deflects. Let's see if it starts killing these off. Deflected. No. But we are going to be with just two left. That's a good thing. is good. Medium healing for Balden. Finish both of them. Valden, critical hit, 124 damage. And this battle's over. ...700 XP. Lots of gold. And some rations. We don't need plain old battle axes.